Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. In our third part of water tank, we will make this tank with this base frame. So I hope you like it. So let's start to create this with the help of sheet metal and weldment tools. Let me choose your file, new, select part. Okay. Now in the third part of water tank, we will make the main water tank with base frame. So let's define it. Let me change image quality also higher. Okay, now we will start with right plane sketch. Let me draw here circle. Okay, let's draw one line from here to here and up to click mirror entity and mirror this line against vertical line. Okay, let's define the diameter 1900 millimeter. This is the diameter for now. Let's make the we will do one thing. Exit, choose here trim entities, power trim, and trim this one. Okay, now let me define the gap, only 1 millimeter. Now see, it is very closed gap. This is useful for sheet metal work. So go to sheet metal. If you don't have, right click and click here sheet metal, select base flange. Now see, now here let's make end condition mid plane. And the length of tank we will keep 4150 millimeter. Okay, now thickness 3.175, this is what we like to keep. And radius corner, it's okay. Bending factor 0.5 is standard, we will keep as it is. Okay, now this body I'll define some dark color. Okay, now here we will make one plane which is very helpful. Top plane, plane, and for plane we will choose one edge. So I'll select this edge. Now see, it's going to be vertical. Select here parallel. Now see, a parallel plane going to create. It is very useful. Okay, let me choose the plane. A sketch, normal, circle. Let me draw here two circles. Now select origin point and both the circle center point and make relation horizontal. That's it. Let's define first. Four hundred millimeter, 108 millimeter. This is the finish. Now this one, 400 millimeter diameter and center distance from outer edge 400 millimeter. Now just go to sheet metal. Here you'll find thickness. Link to thickness. We don't want to cut through all. Okay, it is creating error, so unchecked. Keep 20 millimeter. See, or even actually diameter is bigger, so keep 50 millimeter. Okay, that's it. Now this is going to cover all. Now let me hide this plane. Now let's make the, select this face, sketch, normal. Now here we want to close this face and make sure this one bigger than the tank, and it is 1930 millimeter. It is 30 millimeter just bigger than. Cancel and choose sheet metal, because we are going to create sheet metal things. And thickness, okay, but this is going inside, so just click reverse and unmerge result, so that we will get different sheet metal part. Okay, see, if you will see here, see sheet metal 1, sheet metal 2. Now let's make in another end the same thing. In sheet metal we can't mirror, so sketch normal circle, draw the same circle 1930 millimeter, enter, go to sheet metal, just check thickness, where thickness going is going inside, so let's reverse direction, unchecked, unmerge. Here we will get three number of sheet metal parts. Now let me do some more sketch normal. Now here I'll make some circles, and this diameter 45 millimeter, and distance I will define from inside edge, or hold shift key, if you hold shift key you can directly select any circular things. Now this length keep 100 millimeter, the important relation origin point, and choose circle center vertical, go to sheet metal, choose link thickness, blind, link to thickness, okay, so that it will cut only up to the thickness of plate. Now at bottom also we can create the same hole. We will choose here top plane, sketch normal, let me select here circle, and this diameter 108 millimeter, and this distance from outer edge 200 millimeter. Okay, now I'll select this origin point and this point, so this is the relation what we created. Isometric view, go to sheet metal, extruded cut, and here uncheck, click 1000 so that it will comes out of this backside. Now see, so here we created three number of sheet metal parts. Now let me choose these three parts also, and I'll define some same color. Okay, now we want to create the basic things. Okay, let's make this one also, select the plane one, a sketch normal circle. If you keep your mouse here you have to found. Okay, if you are not going to found, just simply select 400 millimeter and distance from inside line 400 millimeter, and the simple relation origin point and this point horizontal. Isometric view. Now here we want to make a strip sheet metal base flange, cancel it. Just again take normal view. Actually we need to cut. For construction purpose, mirror against this line. Okay, trim entity, power trim and trim this. Now define this distance from here to here, 1 millimeter. Now exit, go to sheet metal, extrude. Now see a sheet metal ring going to extrude in direction 1. Let's keep mid plane 80 millimeter length, so that 40 millimeter down, 40 millimeter up. Just check the thickness, where exactly this is going. Actually thickness should be inside. Okay, if you see sheet metal parts 1, 2, 3, 4, there are 4 number of sheet metal parts. Okay, now let's make the flanges and base columns. So here we will try right plane, plane 1250 millimeter. Let's try from opposite side. Okay, now try the same sketch. What we will do, sketch a plane, sketch normal. Okay, we like to keep this. Now here let me choose hidden line view. Okay, this is better option, center line. Now let me choose here center point arc, and I want to draw one arc from here to here, center line. Let me connect from here to here. Now let's define this angle 40 degree. Now find out this center point, see center point and this vertical line. This distance we need to define, 825 millimeter. Now see, and this radius, now this angle 950 millimeter. Now this is fully defined, so let me choose. Okay, this is what we like to create. Now go to sheet metal and select here isometric view, and this length 200, see it's moving here mid plane. Now that thickness also we will keep here. We need to increase the thickness 9.525. see, but this is going inside, so click reverse, so it comes outside 5 millimeter thickness or radius. Now we need to, okay, that's what we created. In the same way we can just try in other side. So we will choose the same plane, a sketch, a sketch, now we want to draw this side. Or let me directly choose center point arc. Line and connect line from this point to this point. A smart dimension angle 40 degree, and here you will find a center point. If you move, choose center point and this point, vertical length 825 millimeter, and this radius 950 millimeter. This is fully defined, so just go to sheet metal, extrude base flange 200 millimeter, and here define thickness 9.525 millimeter. see, it's going inside, make reverse so that it comes outside. Just rotate it. Mid plane. See. Look. Now it's time to add some pipes here. Now let me choose again this plane, a sketch, normal. I'll select two times. Now here we want to create line. Let me draw a center line and let's vertical line. Make sure it is all the lines are vertical. Mirror about, select this line, mirror. Okay, now even though define the distance also 825 millimeter. Now choose here, we want to connect this with now see, this is inside flange line. Sorry, we need to choose coincident. See, okay, let me choose this point with this point, it should be coincide. Okay, now define the distance from here to here 1260 millimeter. Okay, now make sure both, actually it should be, no need to define, it should be same. exit. Go to weldment. If you don't have, right click and choose weldment here, a structural member, inches, and here choose rectangle tube and 6 by 3 inches. I'll select first this one and this one and make this group 90 degree. See how it looks. Okay, choose this one, define a color so that it looks more visible, red color. Now see, it is coincide, or let's connect it in proper way. Trim and extend, and here choose corner type, bodies to be trimmed. So I'll select these two, and here faces, let me choose this face and this face. See how it's going to extend up to this wall. Okay, now see, now let me hide this. Okay, we will hide it later. Now the same thing we have to make in opposite side. So choose right plane, plane 250 millimeter in this direction. Okay, now again I'll select the same plane, a sketch, normal, center point arc, this is center and this is arc, center line, start from this point to here, a smart dimension 40 degree, center point and this line 825 millimeter, and the radius comes 950 millimeter. It seems perfect. Go to sheet metal, base flange 200, keep mid plane. I'm not going to explain because I already explained everything. 9.525, reverse side. Okay, I'll see, this is the mid plane. Again select the same plane, a sketch, normal, because we want to make the all pieces separately. That's why we are going to mix by separate concentric arc, line, connect with origin point, angle. Degree center point and this center distance 825 millimeter, radius 950 millimeter, sheet metal, base flange. Now let's see, 200 width, mid plane, and here select thickness, overdue default parameter 9.525 millimeter. It comes out, you will see preview here. Okay, now let me hide this plane. Now see, we have one already, this sketch. So okay, select the same plane, sketch, and click the first sketch. See these lines we created, convert entity. Now see, it is mirrored here. Exit. So no need to define furthermore. Go to weldment, structural member, and the same thing, 6 by 3 inch. In first group I'll select this two. Now this is also need to rotate. So for rotation you have to make angle 90 degree. See, both will rotate. Okay. Now both we will align some color. Okay. Now let's extend up to this part and trim unnecessary, which is the inside portion. If you will see there is inside some portion, so we need to trim, and this is a very easy way. Trim and extend portion. Here you can trim and extend also. So let me choose the bodies to be trimmed, these two bodies, and plane and faces, the boundary, trim boundary. See, now you will see how it's going to extend up to this curved surface. Now I'll show you. See, nothing inside. Cancel section view. Now let's hide this planes or sketch. Now I'll choose this face sketch normal. Center line. Now here we will make some center. Now let's make here center rectangle. Find out center point and let me draw one more rectangle. Select this rectangle for construction purpose. This is reference line for ...250 mm... ...160 mm. This inside 120 mm. ...210 mm circle. Now let me select circle here, and this diameter select 13 mm. Okay, even though you can make circulate this one also. This is the center point, and here circle point, just clear and make this is the point. Okay, this is not going to be, because this circle is not equivalent, so let's make one by one separate. Select all circle at a time, make relation equal. And here also select this also. Okay. Multiple number of same thing. Make sure it is vertical. Now select this whole geometry, mirror about this line. Mirror about this line. Okay. Now again select the whole rectangle, mirror about. This line. Now see the preview. Okay. Now it is mirror. Need to extrude. And this thickness is 9.525 mm. Now look. Now this bottom part you can differentiate with the help of yellow color. Now select these two flanges and make little dark color so that it looks more visible. Select this. Okay. So here we completed our tank. Now some more things balance actually. Weldment 3D sketch. Draw, find out center point. Go upward side. The same thing we have to repeat in all lines. Center point, just go upward. Make sure line it should be make inside. In vertical. Let's make the last line. Now select all the lines equal. Okay. And define any one. 385, this is the maximum length we like to define. Line. Now connect from here. We want to go in opposite side, so just press tab key and see arrow shows. Just press right click. What we will do, select end point and this line, merge. See, it moves. One more relation, select this tank and this line. Here one relation, tangent relation comes. Now see, this line is fully defined. Let's try to mirror this line, either possible. Right plane. We need to actually make a copy entities. Okay, let's try to create better option. Line. Click on the line. It goes this direction. Now select this line and this center end point. Hold shift key. Merge. Tank and select this line. Tangent relation. Now this fully defined. Let me connect from the end point to the end point. Now let's connect this end point. To this end point. That's why we make. Oh, okay, here not connected. Merge. Now the drawing is fully defined. It's time to weldments. Exit sketch. Weldment structure. The same thing, 3 by 6 by 3 inch. In group 1, we will try these two. See? This is perfectly located, no need to change anything. Okay, even in the same way, edit feature, we can define this two also. So simply select group one. Let me choose this one. Now see, we need to define, come down and here choose locate profile. So location of profile at this end. So just rotate. And which point we like to choose? We will choose this point. Now see how it is shifted. See, new group, this one. Again here locate profile, and here also we need to define this end point. Now see, it is shifted downward. Okay, now see, everything is fully defined, but this one goes inside, so we need to trim. So again we will use the same trim bodies to be trimmed. So 1, 2 and trim boundary. So here let's try with body. So trim boundary 2, 3, 4, these are the bodies. See, this is the yellow part, is the remaining part. And allow extension, like this extension, which extension do you like? So we will keep this one. Okay, now see, you will see the gap. Let's define color red. Okay, now let me hide all the sketches. So this is the our part number third, tank with base frame. Few accessories are balanced, we will make that accessories in next lecture. This may be little bigger, but I hope you like it, even though we will do the assembly also. So don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks and Autodesk Inventor. Thanks for watching.